Hello and welcome everyone to Daily Motors' first tier list. Now we've been getting so many requests to make a list like this, and honestly, we've been looking forward to making one. We get to spend so much time in all sorts of different cars, and the tier list is a fun way to rank so many aspects of these cars while ruffling a little feathers along the way. Today we're starting off with our most asked for tier list, sound systems. Now after thinking about the many ways we could go about ranking sound systems, we decided to rank by brand. Obviously, there is a vast spectrum of sound quality from a base Mercedes A250 all the way up to a top-level Burmester in a GLS class, but looking at average sound system quality across a brand allows for a very simple comparison between systems and between makes. Now, we're only including brands I've tested at least two examples of. I know this isn't a huge sample size, but with all things considered, we should be able to make a pretty solid case. And we know there are many of you who'd like to see Jaguar, Land Rover, or Audi on this list, so hopefully we can get a few more of those in soon. Let's jump right into it. Coming in at the bottom of the list, at no surprise to anyone who's owned or driven one of these, is Honda. Honda makes excellent cars in every category. While they're not all impressive on paper, when you get behind the wheel or really from any seat, they feel solid, well-built, and are usually pretty satisfying to drive. We always get excited when we've got a Honda coming in, but we never want to take one on a road trip. Why? Because all of their sound systems are garbage. It doesn't matter if it's a top trim Odyssey, a bargain, Fit, or the rowdy Civic Type R, each one sounds hollow and poorly mixed. If you want a Honda and you care about sound quality from your system, just plan on fitting aftermarket speakers. However, there are rumors that Honda may be moving to a branded audio system in some future models, so if that proves to be true, we might have a re-rank on our hands sometime soon. Now, jumping right up to the D tier, these systems might sound impressive at first or sport big numbers for speakers or max power, but once you turn up some complex music, you'll realize you might just be better off popping in some earbuds. First off, we've got Stellantis. Now, who in the world is that, you ask? You might know them better as FCA. Still doesn't ring a bell? Fiat Chrysler, maybe? There we go. This newly formed company combines Fiat Chrysler and Peugeot to form a new mega car company, Stellantis. Now for us Yanks, that encompasses Alfa Romeo, Chrysler, Dodge, Fiat, Jeep, and Ram. But it doesn't matter what sub-brand, model, or speaker brand, all of these overpromise and underdeliver when it comes to their audio systems. We've had the 19-speaker Durango in here, we've had the Ram, we've had Jeeps, we've had all sorts of different models from this brand, and each one sports big numbers and big wattages, but fails to deliver from behind the wheel. Next up in the D tier is Nissan. Nissan's had a partnership with Bose for nearly two decades now, and their sound quality sounds just as stale. Many people like to bash on Bose, but not all of their systems are bad. However, all Nissan systems are, Bose are not. This includes Infiniti, Nissan's luxury brand. Now, it's not that each Infiniti sounds just as good as a Nissan car, but if you're paying more, you should be getting more, and all you're getting out of any of these systems for your money is D-tier quality. Now, last in the D-tier is Chevrolet, another brand that's relied on Bose for several years and also doesn't seem to care too much about audio quality. Chevys, and we're going to throw GMC in here as well, are at least helped by having some of the best infotainment systems for a mainstream brand. There is one Chevy that is exempt from the D rating though, so stay tuned for that. C tier. Now we're getting somewhere. These systems will be perfectly acceptable for casual listeners and casual listening. Some of the premium models and systems from these brands might actually sound really good, but lower models are still nothing to write home about, and you'll have to pony up to get the good ones. First up is Ford. The Blue Oval has always managed to maintain a small advantage over its domestic counterparts in the audio game, with even their base systems managing to carry a bit of power. They've hopped between a few different premium speaker brands over the years, but their latest partnership with Harman and the B&O brand seems to be paying off. The B&O Unleashed system and the 2021 Ford F-150 really impressed us. Ford's Sync infotainment has progressed slowly but surely, and it's always straightforward to use. Now if you own a Toyota, you may be surprised to find it in the C tier. Or maybe you won't. Toyota's partnership with JBL results in some great systems and some real disappointments. For example, the Avalon and the Camry were sloppy and weak in our testing, but the Highlander and RAV4 carried serious power. This unpredictability, along with really poor infotainment, lands Toyota smack dab in the C tier. Now Volkswagen is the opposite of Toyota. all of their systems are just decent. The Fender systems sound okay for a premium option, and the Volkswagen bass radios are really okay for their prices as well. Their infotainment's simple but effective, and like the rest of their cars, the VW systems just get the job done and that's about it. Now, Kia nearly escaped the C-Class, but we couldn't for the life of us remember an outstanding Kia sound system, so there's really no reason for it to be awarded a higher tier. Most music will sound okay in any Kia, but audiophiles really can do better. Last up in this large C tier is Subaru. Subaru sports Harman Kardon for their premium systems, but they're on the weaker end of Harman Kardon's offerings. A Subaru may have won itself a B tier if it weren't for the horrendous WRX system. You'd be better taping off a Bluetooth speaker to the dashboard of your STI than using those stock speakers. Finally, the brands that have it down. B tier brands have solid radios in every model they make, and their premium offerings are truly class leading. For mainstream brands, this is about as good as it gets. First up is Cadillac. Cadillac is demanding more respect in the luxury car game, and overall they've been earning it with their audio systems. While the older Bose models aren't anything to write home about, the new Escalade with its 36-speaker AKG Studio could carry 1,000 crappy Bose systems to the B tier. If Cadillac keeps with this trend, they will be moving their way up to the top. Our next B tier brand, and one of the two mainstream brands here, although they'd probably like to distance themselves from the mainstream label, is Mazda. See? Not all Bose systems are bad. We should mention that we haven't tested any of Mazda's bass radios, but every top trim system sounds solid, and the newest CX-30 and 3 systems are their best yet. Some may not care for the rotary knob infotainment systems, but if you get used to it, it's a pretty good setup. Now, the Miata doesn't sound great over all the road and wind noise, but no one buys a Miata for the radio. Now, this next one might really ruffle some feathers, but our next B-tier system is Tesla. While we haven't published a sound system test on a Tesla yet, we have spent extended time in the Model 3, Y, and S, and all of their systems sound great. Their downfall is Tesla's decision to focus most of the sound in front of the driver, which may be preferable in some audiophile circles, but for most casual listeners, music sounds flatter than in vehicles that surround their occupants. But, you claim, Teslas have a surround mode, problem solved. Nope, that sounds artificial and exaggerates select elements of the music while losing others. Now, if you really crank the music up and you're listening at loud volumes, Teslas sound really great. But if you're listening at easy volumes, softer music, you lose some of the aspects of the music that make other systems sound as cool. Teslas have excellent speakers and power, and with better mixing, they'd be a solid A tier. The next mainstream brand in the B list is Hyundai, and it just barely makes the cut. It earns this spot by providing a better than average sound experience in every car they make. Their top Bose and Harman Kardon systems are pretty darn solid, but they're further from A tier than some of these brands. BMW lands itself in the B tier not because their systems sound the same as Hyundai and Mazda, but because they don't provide A or S levels of value. Top BMW, Bowers, and Wilkins systems sound great, but the amount you have to shell out to get the privilege to listen one is pitiful. You might try to make the same argument for other luxury brands, but their cheaper systems don't sound as basic as BMW's. Not only that, but the Harman Kardon systems in BMW's require an immense amount of tuning just to get them to sound adequate. For that, they're landing in the B tier. Now, the last B tier brand loves to overpromise and underdeliver, and if they don't settle down, they're gonna find themselves in the C tier next time. Lincoln loves to brag about how many speakers their Revel systems feature, but we've heard more impressive audio from half as many speakers. Fortunately, the top Revel systems sound great, and the cheaper systems really aren't too bad either. Cadillac provides more with some cars and less with others, but Lincoln earns a higher ranking by being more solid overall. Bonus! The new C8 Corvette's Bose system is so great, especially for a sports car, that it deserves a ranking far removed from the rest of the Chevy brand. Now, if every Bose system sounded this impressive, they'd have a lot more respect. A-tier brands. To make it to A-tier, you really have to stand out, and we can easily remember testing each of these systems and, more importantly, enjoying them. Lexus, the first of our two A-tier brands, exhibits a similar inconsistency to its parent brand, Toyota. The GX460 remains one of the best systems we've ever tested, but the RCF was remarkably unremarkable. As a whole, Mark Levinson's systems ensure great, if not outstanding, sound quality for everything from easy listening classical to full-blown metal. They also offer nearly every audio input on every system they make. Now, if they could only improve their infotainment systems, they might sneak their way into S tier next time. Second up is Genesis. Now, unlike Lexus, every Genesis we've tested has a solid A+ sound system. They barely miss the sheer power and balance of the S tier radios, and we think the rotary in the GV80 is actually a step backward from the knob in their sedans, but at least all the screens are touchable at any speed. Last up in the A tier comes Acura. Interestingly enough, when I wrote this list, it was before we had tested the new MDX and its 16-speaker ELS 3D system, and we actually had Acura in the S tier. We were thoroughly impressed with the TLS ELS system, and we heard that the MDX was even better. This, along with Acura's clear dedication to building a reputation in the sound system game, led us to initially giving them an S-tier ranking. However, the 2021 MDX did not live up to our expectations, and therefore we dropped Acura down to A. Still an incredibly impressive ranking, but not at the tippy-tippy top. And finally, the S-tier. These brands not only provide top-notch sound quality across their lineup, but their premium offerings give us goosebumps. The engineers and designers care about audio quality, and their marketing departments know their customers care about audio too. First up is Mercedes-Benz. Not only are some of our favorite systems found in Mercs, but even the base cars like the GLA and A-Class have impressive sound systems for their prices. Newer Mercedes-Benzes have been all about being showy, and some of their sound settings border on gimmicky, especially in the Burmester 3D systems. But people generally appreciate feeling like they're getting something in return for paying for the top system. Not only do their sound systems sound great, but they look the part too, with beautiful, artfully crafted speaker grills and even tweeters that raise up out of the dash. Mercedes audio is a better value than BMW, hands down. Unfortunately, we haven't tested enough Audis to include them into the mix, but as soon as we get some seat time behind the radio of some more, we will absolutely put them in. Last up on the list, and our personal favorite, is Volvo. Whenever we have a Volvo on the schedule, we get excited to listen to all of our favorite loud, complex music. Pop in some uncompressed tracks and be submerged in the best balance between pure sound and enhancement that the new car market has to offer. You get a few gimmicks with the top Bowers & Wilkins systems, such as a sound mode that replicates the Gothenburg Symphonic Orchestra Hall, but these are easy enough to ignore if that's not your thing. It doesn't matter if it's a sedan, wagon, or SUV, or if it's just a mid-level Harman Kardon option, any Volvo is impressive. You don't need to spend top dollar to get an amazing car system, you just have to order from Sweden. Or China. So there you go, Daily Motors' first tier list. Let us know in the comments what you think of these. We're looking forward to making more of these type of videos, so if there's a specific topic you'd like to see ranked, let us know. Do you agree or disagree with any of these rankings? Well, they're not changing until the next one, but tell us anyway. I'm Charlie from Daily Motor, and as always, drive on.